A person of height 6 feet wants to pluck a fruit which is on a 26 by 3 feet high tree. If the person is standing 8 by root 3 feet away from the base of the tree, then at what angle should he throw a stone so that it hits the fruit? So same concept of heights and distance, where we use the, you know, trigonometric ratio tan theta to solve most of the questions, has been given in an interesting fashion, right? Here is talking about a person of height 6 feet who wants to pluck a fruit which is on a 26 by 3 feet high tree. Yeah, he is standing at 8 by root 3 feet away from the tree. So at what angle should he throw the stone so that it hits the fruit? Okay, there's an underlying assumption here. I mean, if you ask me, strictly speaking, answer cannot be determined to such question. Yeah, but there are some basic assumptions that we need to consider. Let's say this is the ground level, right? This is the ground level. Now, here's the tree. What's the height of the tree? 26 by 3. And this is the person, right? The person's height is 6 feet. 6 feet, right? So here is a person and this is a tree. The distance between these two is 8 by root 3, right? He is 8 by root 3 feet away. 8 by root 3 feet away, right? So approximately like around 5 feet away, let's say, approximately. Now, if you see, this is what we get. This is the line of angle of elevation, right? This is what we need. So he is throwing the stone in this direction. Yeah, in this direction, like this. Here is the fruit, basically. Here is the fruit. So at what angle should he throw the stone? At what should be theta? So that his stone, which is thrown from here, hits the fruit. It should hit the fruit. Now, why did I say that answer cannot be determined strictly, logically? Because one is, you are assuming that he will throw the stone from the top of his head. Usually that doesn't happen. I mean, there is, when you're throwing a stone, it usually falls like this. Yeah, it will not be a straight line, but assuming that he throws in a straight line and it shoots from the top of his head. Because otherwise, if he's shooting the stone or throwing the stone from his hand, it won't be at 6 feet high, right? I mean, it can be like, if he's lifting his hand up, it can be 7 feet, 7.5 feet. Or if he's like trying to throw it from the bottom, it can be like 5 feet. But then let's not worry about all those things, right? Let's take it for granted that the stone is thrown from the height of 6 feet. Yeah. And the other assumption is that the fruit is exactly on top of the tree, which is not usually the case, right? We are assuming that the fruit is sitting on top of the tree, which is 26 by 3 feet high. Yeah. So those are the assumptions, but you know, it doesn't matter. What do we have to do? Simple. Apply tan theta. Apply tan theta. You know that this is 8 by root 3. Because these two are parallel. All we have to do is, out of the total height of the tree, what is this height has to be evaluated? This h has to be found. How much will that be? See, h will be equal to total height 26 by 3 minus the height of the person 6. So how much will that give you? 26 minus 18 is 8 by 3. So if you consider this right angle triangle, let's say this is the point P. Yeah. So the right angle triangle SPF. SPF. This has got SP as 8 by root 3 and PFS. Sorry, this is not 8 by root 3. This is 8 by 3. Apologies. This is 8 by 3. 8 by 3. This is 8 by 3. You have to find out theta. What is tan theta? Tan theta is opposite side by adjacent side. Yeah. So I can say tan theta equals to 8 by 3. 8 by 3 upon 8 by root 3. So 8 and 8 gets cancelled. What do we get? Root 3 by 3. Root 3 by 3 is 1 by root 3. So for what value of theta is tan theta 1 by root 3? For 30 degrees. So we can conclude that theta is equals to 30 degrees. 30 degrees, which is option 2.
The base of a right pyramid is a square and the length of the diagonal of the base is 14 root 2 meters. If the volume of the pyramid is 4508 meter cube, then its height is dash. How do you solve this? The base of a right pyramid is a square. So the base is a square. Okay, so you have a pyramid like this and the base of the pyramid is a square and the length of the diagonal of its base is 14 root 2. So this length is given as 14 root 2 and you have to find the volume. Okay, volume is given, you have to find the height. So what is the volume of a pyramid? Volume of a pyramid is equal to 1 by 3rd into the height into area of the base. Okay, so this is the general volume for any pyramid, any given pyramid. So here, I don't know, I know the volume is 4508, yes, is equal to 1 by 3 into height. I don't know what the height is, okay, height into area of the base. What is the area of the base? See, if one diagonal is 14 root 2, then what is the area? I can either take, if this is a root 2 is 14, right? A root 2 is 14 root 2, or I can say a is equal to 14. So the area of the base a squared is equal to 14 into 14, that is 196. Or if you know this formula, right? Area of a square is also given as half into the diagonal squared. Directly you can use this also, still you will get the answer as 196. So here 4508 is equal to 1 by 3 into height into 196. So what is the height of the this thing? It is nothing but 4508 into 3 by 196. What is the answer that you get here? You get the answer as 69 meters. That is option 1.